aftermarket screens that are IC transplantable. For the iPhone 14 and 14 Plus are now available. However, the IC transplant procedure for the iPhone 14 and 14 Plus differs slightly from the iPhone 12 and 13 series. Here's the difference. In this video, we'll demonstrate IC transplant from an iPhone 14 to an aftermarket screen to eliminate the "no part" message. Before transplanting the IC, restore the True Tone function, as the aftermarket screen does not store True Tone data. Connect the original screen to a programmer to read the True Tone data. Connect the aftermarket screen to the programmer to write in the True Tone data. Install the aftermarket screen to verify the True Tone function. True Tone is restored on the aftermarket screen. Still, the display "unknown part" message remains. The next step is to remove the Touch IC from the original screen. Apply some alcohol around the IC. Insert a metal plate for heat insulation to protect the screen. Apply high temperature tape around the IC to prevent heat damage to the screen. Heat the IC with hot air gun at 370 degrees Celsius and airflow 3 to desolder the IC. Heat the area evenly with the nozzle 1 cm away from the IC, in a vertical manner for about 6 to 8 seconds. After the IC is removed, apply middle temperature solder paste and flux to the IC. Flatten the bonding pads with soldering iron at 380 degrees Celsius. Use desoldering braid and soldering iron at 380 degrees Celsius to remove tin. Clean the bonding pads with PCB cleaner. Remove adhesive with hot air gun at 300 degrees Celsius. Then apply some middle temperature solder paste to reball the IC. Form the solder balls with hot air gun at 300 degrees Celsius. To transplant the original IC to the aftermarket screen, you need to use a SUGON flex. Apply some flux to the SUGON flex. Remove tin with desoldering braid and soldering iron at 380 degrees Celsius. Clean the bonding pads with PCB cleaner. Align the IC with the tag on flex. Apply some flux to the tag on flex. Solder the IC to the tag on flex with hot air gun at 320 degrees Celsius and airflow 3. Bend over the screen flex gently to show its opposite side. Peel off the black cover tape from the screen flex. To reveal the testing points, save the black cover tape for later use. Peel off the liner from the tag on flex. Align the pins of the tag on flex to the screen testing points. And then secure them together. Apply some middle temp solder paste to the testing points. Solder the tag on flex to the screen testing points with soldering iron at 380 degrees Celsius. Clean residue with PCB cleaner. Reattach the black cover tape to cover the testing points. Next, install the aftermarket screen. Remove the foam padding from the rear housing to make space for the transplanted IC. True tone is restored. The unknown part display message is gone. The screen is fully functional. IC transplant can be challenging and may risk screen damage. Leave us a comment if you have any question about IC transplant. The parts, tools, and consumables used in the video are listed in the description section. Thank you for watching.